crashed in the crater on Saturday. And prosecutors in Michigan are urging state legislators to make a crime out of assisting suicides. The issue could come up today in Michigan State House. The call comes one day after suicide doctor Jack Kevorkian assisted another terminal cancer patient in killing herself. Prosecutors say without a law, they won't file charges against Kevorkian. Weather-wise today, cloudy with patchy drizzle this morning. We'll have highs in the low 40s. Rain again tonight, low around 40, and rain again tomorrow. Windy and chilly tomorrow with highs in the low 40s. And it's traffic time once again, Jim.
And things getting better. Eden's inbound. Lake Hook to Montrose, 20 minutes. Back to Lake Hook, outbound, 30 minutes. Kennedy, O'Hare to downtown, 45. For Montrose, 35. 16 in the express lanes. Outbound to O'Hare, about a half hour. Ike inbound, 53 to the post office. A little over an hour. That's not too good. To 53, though, outbound is about 47 minutes. Stevenson, north-south to Lakeshore, about an hour or three. 40 minutes from Harlem. The Ryan 95th to downtown, 40 minutes. But things a lot better on the Cal and 57 northbound. It's about 18 minutes from 80 to the Ryan. Lakeshore is pretty good both ways. The Tri-State northbound, Stevenson to the Kennedy, about 25 minutes. North-south, 53 northbound from Stevenson to the Northwest Tollway, about 43 minutes. The other tollway is pretty good, even the Northwest eastbound better. Barrington Road to the Kennedy now, 25 minutes. A disabled car in Bensonville, northbound Route 83 is heavy, approaching Irving Park Road with a stall in the center lane. And the inbound Metra Electric Line trains are stopped before Harvey because of a train versus pedestrian accident that's in Harvey. This report brought to you by All Price Auto Sales. Now you can get credit without a cosigner and regardless of your past credit. Everyone qualifies when they call All Price Auto Sales, 708-991-7080. 708-991-7080. Jim Volkman, Shadow Traffic at 830 and AM 1000.
So, you want to work for BIFCO Corporation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. How much do you know about personal computers?
A fair amount.
Then what is the capital of Uzbekistan?
What?
What color was kryptonite?
But
how much did Orson Welles weigh?
But how does this relate to personal computers?
Well, what do you know about the Microsoft mouse?
It's great for the Windows operating system.
Did you know
system?
That right now when you buy selected Microsoft mouse products, you get a free Trivial Pursuit daily planner?
No.
Well, that's the kind of computer knowledge we expect here at BIFCO.
Okay. Try me again.
Did you know that the Trivial Pursuit Daily Planner has a value of almost $70?
Yeah, I knew that.
That it's a limited time offer?
I knew that, too.
How many years does a tree toad live?
What?
We'll get back to you.
Now you can buy selected Microsoft mouse and ballpoint mouse products at new low prices. And Microsoft will give you a free Trivial Pursuit Daily Planner from Amaze, Inc. Available at participating resellers. Offer good while supplies last or for the approximate lifespan of a tree toad.
If you can sleep on it, you can save on it during the incredible mattress sale at Montgomery Ward.
Because right now, all mattresses are 20 to 50% off.
Save 20 to 50% off Sealy, Serta, Spring Air, and Simmons. All four of America's leading mattress brands available only at Montgomery Ward.
And you'll rest easy knowing Montgomery Ward has a 110% price match guarantee.
As well as a 30-day comfort pledge that makes sure if you're not satisfied, we'll issue a complete refund.
Plus, your new mattress can be delivered the next day.
And Montgomery Ward will haul away your old mattress for free when they deliver the new one.
Prices start as low as $49.99 for each piece of twin set.
So set your alarms early for this amazing mattress sale now at Montgomery Ward. Why shop anywhere else?
Next day delivery available Tuesday through Sunday on in-stock purchases made before 3 p.m. See mattress pickup and 110% price match guarantee details in store.
Now get a Simmons Ultramax pillow top mattress for only $99.99 each piece in twin sets. Montgomery Ward mattress sale ends December 12th. Excludes super buys.
11 and a half minutes into the Hawks-Canucks game, this sequence occurred.
Now the Canucks try to move in. Jeff Cortnall in traffic for Ajik. Centering net, Ben Reddy, and has Belfour down, and he scores. Had Belfour down early. Peter Nedved showing the calm approach of a veteran player, held on to it till Belfour went for a swim, and it's 1-0 Vancouver.
I like the stadium goal sounder better. Downhill from there, Vancouver wins at 5-2. Ajik, two goals plus an assist. Larmer back on the scoring ledger. First goal in 14 games. The first on the road this season. He barely missed earlier in the game. Larmer was almost sat down by Sutter, but the third longest streak in NHL history alive at 8:23. The Hawks 3 points behind Detroit, who crushed Tampa 10-5. The 1-3 trip continues Friday night in Edmonton. An early happy Thanksgiving to the Hawks. Monday Night Football. At the Superdome, Saints 20, Redskins 3. Washington got a 19-play, 10-minute drive. They only got a field goal early. Then two TDs. They've only scored two TDs, the champs have, in their last 23 quarters. New Orleans now 8-3. Washington 6-5. Now, tomorrow at Hallis Hall, the announcement will be made. Harbaugh or Willis at quarterback Sunday in Cleveland. Now, the Browns aren't sure who's going to start for them, either Tezak, Philcox, or Kosar. The Vikings will start Salisbury for Gannon Sunday. The Bengals will start rookie Klingler for Assize and for the rest of the season. College ball, Earl Bruce fired as coach of Colorado State for creating a climate of intimidation and fear for the players. He broke down at the press conference. We'll hear it next hour. It was almost like that. Rodman's back with the Pistons. The Celtics lost their 6 in a row. They're 2-8, and the Bulls try and go 9-2 tonight against the Warriors in Oakland. That's the sports at 8:34, and I'm Jim Volkman.
Following Howard Stern, keep it on AM 1000 for Kev and the Midday Show. Then, this afternoon, Jonathan Brandmeier will drive you home. On The Loop, your AM 1000. The Howard Stern Show contains adult themes and material that might be offensive to some. Parental discretion is advised.
Now we're moving on up. Hours number one now. Those two sparklers, Mark and Brian, are going down.
Yeah.
The city of L.A. rejoices in the defeat of Mark and Jackass. Here's Howard Stern.
Yes, Mark and Jackass, two idiots.
You know, I feel bad for the other guy because his name always gets butchered in those things.
Yeah, Jackass always gets... We don't even know the other guy's name. By the way, we're here at Spago. Tomorrow is the big show when we have the funeral outdoors. Today is the day that celebrities come by and welcome us into show business. Do here still at Asner. A couple other people. And also, I see out in our audience, Jack Nicholson's daughter is here. And,
Jennifer.
Of course, Jennifer Nicholson. Victoria Sellers is here. Mark Harris is here, who will be performing tomorrow.
Right.
Who is wearing, we just figured out, Mark Harris is wearing a winter coat here. It's 100 degrees in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
But we figured it out. He just wanted to be fashionably dressed. In fact, we think it's Martha Ray's coat he's wearing.
I think it is.
Because it's not even a man's coat. Is that your coat?
It's mine.
It is yours.
Designed it myself.
You will be singing a song parody tomorrow?
California, Stern is on.
And you wrote this yourself?
Wrote it.
Oh, is that to California, Here We Come? In the right ballpark?
Parodying that.
Very good,
Forget your troubles.
Well, and forget your troubles.
Right. Yeah, my choreographer is here. I'm going to do the whole nine yards.
Your choreographer.
And Martha Ray will be there as well?
No, she has other things to do.
She will. She is busy. She's shooting tomorrow?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Near the house.
No, she's going to shoot herself. She's married to you.
Martha has to get out of bed.
Yeah. She has things to do. She's rolling down Rodeo Drive.
Mark is already...
Purchasing.
Mark is already making, funny requests. Like, he wanted a lavalier or a headset because I guess his choreography is so intense that he needs hands-free to perform.
Well, that should be really wild.
He's going to turn so much, he's going to screw himself right through the stage.
Where are we going to put him in the lineup? We have to, later on today, plan the lineup.
That's
where
right.
We put someone like... Mark Harris is a show closer, if you ask me. He's a showstopper.
Well, he needs a special place.
Right. Martha Ray's husband will be there. Mr. Martha Ray.
Mr. Doing, Martha Ray.
Doing Come On, Forget Your Troubles and...
Forget Your Troubles and Listen to Howard.
Okay.
See, I've already heard the song.
Can I hear a little bit of that? Just a tease? Come on.
A little tease. California Stern is on. L.A. is number one. Howard Stern's the best of all. Listen to Howard and you'll know.
All right.
That's
very,
a tease.
All right,
wait, the best part is it's right in the middle of that.
Yeah.
And it's like, bang. Forget Your Troubles. Come on.
Don't give it away.
Oh, come on.
So beautiful.
I bet you he lasts 20 seconds in the audience, booze him off stage.
It reminds me a lot
of
what I'm saying.
We'll see. He's going to have the outfit that he designed.
It's true, the outfit. What outfit will you wear?
Well, let's just say it's royal blue, some black velvet here and there, blue suede boots, black cane, the whole thing.
The whole nine yards. It's
absolutely.
It just says it'll blow away Michael Jackson's outfit.
It's very reminiscent of Judy Garland at Carnegie Hall.
I think tomorrow...
It's a combination of Judy and Fred Astaire.
I think tomorrow Yoko will be holding her ears.
Oh, she'll love it.
Yes, okay. Very good. Mark Harris. All right, John. Leave Mark alone and sit there by himself. What is it?
Oh, I just was telling you about Tori Spelling.
By the way, Tori Spelling was just here, the star of Beverly Hills 90210, the daughter of Aaron Spelling.
She's got a great body.
She really does.
She really does. She's a great body. She was wearing... You couldn't notice, but I was behind leering at her. She was wearing that white outfit that was low cut. It was a... I guess
leotard.
It's a dance skin, right?
Right.
So when she leaned over, her... her jeans, you know, sort of went down, and she was wearing like a thong underwear under that.
Really? So you mean her, so she was like wearing thong underwear?
You have amazing eyes.
I see what I need to see.
You have no idea what amazing eyes he has. Wait till I tell you about Saturday night when I called up Jessica Hahn to do a lingerie show in my room.
Uh-huh.
Gary and I had to supervise her, the changing of Jessica Hahn.
You were her dressers?
Last night at 4 o'clock over at the hotel, we had a lesbian show. We had two lesbians come up for an hour and put on a performance.
It wasn't what you think it was.
Yeah,
it was more like a lesson.
There was a lesbian lesson with a question and answer. First, do I have time to talk about this?
Yeah.
Well, why don't we just say a quick hello to Jennifer Nicholson and Victoria Sellers? Why don't you get the microphone on them?
He just pulled his underwear out of his butt in front of me.
I know.
Sorry, Robin.
Gary, why don't you buy a belt? Bring the girls up here. Bring them up here real quick so I can meet them.
Baba Booey. Stuck.
Wow, look at Peter Sellers' daughter. Man, what a body on you. What are you, an aerobics instructor?
No, I just work out a lot.
You look like Peter.
Really?
Except you got a really nice feminine body. And those aren't breast implants?
No.
They aren't? You're cute.
Thanks.
You're Peter Sellers' daughter?
Now, who was your mom?
She's still alive.
She is Britt Eklund.
Really?
Britt Eklund.
We know her.
Cool.
We do? Yes, we do.
Yeah, we do?
Babylonia.
I know her? Babylonia. She is a Babylonia. Look at you. Did you? So Peter Sellers leave you a lot of money?
Not a dime.
Really?
Scumbag.
Really?
Oh. I'm kidding.
And your name is Victoria, right? What do you got, a tattoo on your ankle? Let me see that.
How can you see her ankle?
What are you going to show me?
What?
What are you going to show me?
I'll show you something after this show. You're not going to know what hit you.
Oh,
look at that.
It's all the way around.
Yeah, you're definitely weird. That's cool.
I never said I wasn't.
You're cute, man. I bet you have a lot of sex.
How come you don't have an accent? You grew up here?
Yeah.
You have a lot of sex?
Yeah.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
With two girls at the same time?
No.
No, ever have lesbianism?
I'd only be a lesbian with one person.
Who's that?
Can't say. Famous person.
Who would it be?
Madonna.
You would be a lesbian with Madonna?
I'd do anything she wanted me to do.
Really? You're that much in love with her?
That much. What is it about her?
I don't know, but she just hits my spot.
Really?
You would be a lesbian with Madonna? I bet you she might be interested in that.
Mark, can
do you know how
that.
I can get in touch with her?
Yeah, I know her personally. I'll get you two hooked up tonight if I can watch.
All right.
You would?
Okay.
And you're not turned on by any other women?
No.
Poor
but
Peter,
Madonna.
Peter Sellers is rolling over in his grave right now.
He's face down now.
So you hate Peter Sellers because he didn't leave you with any money?
No, I don't hate him at all.
Yeah, but he wasn't a good guy, was he?
Yeah, he was.
He is a good guy.
You remember?
Yeah. His wife got all the money, but she's a...
Oh, geez.
Well, wait a second. Let's just say something. That's your opinion. Of course, we don't know if that's true or
we
not.
Like
we like
her.
We like her.
We like her.
Well, that's your business. I have no idea if that's true or not. And Peter Sellers died, and how old were you when he died?
15
years old. Did you get to see him a lot, or you never saw him?
No, I saw him a lot.
Yeah.
I saw him during summer and Christmas and whatever, Easter.
Did he ever sexually molest you?
Oh, dear.
Darn no.
No. I don't know. Maybe it has some kind of weird story.
Why.
No, he just got married to another woman and she got all the money. That's all the deal.
Oh, I see. That's all you're upset about. And he didn't remember his only daughter.
He has another daughter and another son from a different mother.
I see. So you were just upset that he'd give all his money to another woman and not give some to
his
daughter.
Not all, but a large sum.
A large sum. Now, you're Jack Nicholson's daughter, right?
Yeah.
Now, do you want to have sex with Madonna?
No.
You do not. What about Jack? Do you ever get to see him?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
And who's your mother?
Sandra Knight.
Sandra Knight. Oh, I'm sure she's a fine piece of ass if Jack has.
Oh,
I'll tell you that.
Thank you.
I'll tell you that. Oh, man. Does Jack listen to me? Is Jack a fan of mine?
I don't know.
When's the last time you saw Jack?
I saw him a week ago.
A week ago? Where do you go?
To his house.
To his house, and you get to eat dinner with him?
Yeah, daughters get to do that.
Really? And you just hang with him?
Definitely.
Oh, cool. Yeah, oh, that's excellent. You get to
now, how is it when you see him with the new kids?
Oh, it's got to be torture.
I get a little jealous, I have to say.
You do.
Because now he's being the good dad. I love
They're
these guys.
He wasn't such a good dad to you, though, right? Because he was hardly around.
He was busy.
Well, he was a good dad, but...
I'm sorry, I don't have time for you right now.
Now I'm watching the kids grow.
Yeah, now I have time to be like a really good father. But, you know, with you, I just, you know, you can come visit me once in a while. But make sure you call first.
Don't bother me now, Jennifer. I'm doing flashcards.
Yeah, do you have to call him before you come over and stuff?
I don't have to, but I do.
You do. You call him. Excuse me, Mr. Nicholson, can I come see you? It's got to be weird. And does he set up a trust fund for you?
A trust fund? No.
He's probably a billionaire at this point from all the Batman money.
Yeah, really?
We've made very wise investments.
Oh, what do you mean? We?
We.
Meaning you?
Yes.
How did you get the money? Did you get money from him? Does he support you?
A little.
He does? Mm-hmm. Excellent. Well, that's better than you did with Peter Sellers.
Damn right.
Hey, what do you do, work out or something, man? You got some body on you. Peter Sellers' daughter's like in training for something. What age did you start having sex, Peter Sellers' daughter?
17, but not really good sex till after I saw Basic Instinct.
Yeah, and you started...
Oh, well, that was just recent.
Yeah.
What were you doing?
Ever have two guys at the same time?
Yeah, and they both sucked.
Ever? What about... You need me, honey, I'll tell you that.
Oh,
you're not
dear.
Wearing a bra, obviously. I can see that.
I never do.
And this. You're getting turned on by this conversation. All that. You really are turned on right now, aren't you?
I totally
are you turned
am.
On by my number one status in Los Angeles?
Really, I am.
Ever posed nude in a magazine? You did, didn't you? You posed nude in a magazine?
What magazine?
What magazine did you pose nude in?
We. No, I'm kidding.
What, did you pose nude in a magazine? You did? What magazine?
Long time ago. I was like 12 years old.
You're kidding me.
No.
You were naked? You were naked as a 12-year-old?
You are so
no,
advanced.
I was naked as a 20-year-old.
As a 20-year-old? No kidding. Well, you're embarrassed by that?
Not really.
Man, I'd love to see that.
But kind of like straightforward, yeah.
Well, you know, you got to wonder, you know, she's growing up with like a guy named Slim Jim is her dad or
no,
something.
No, he's not. My mother divorced him.
She divorced Slim Jim? Your mother divorced Slim Jim?
Yeah, I heard they just broke up or something.
Were you turned on by Slim Jim? Hey, you ever seen your mother naked?
Are you turned on by Aunt Jim... Aunt Jemima?
As a matter of fact, I am. In fact, I got in trouble for it.
You got in trouble for that.
No,
I'm not turned on by him at all.
Are you turned on by Aunt Jemima? So wait a second. Your mom, Britt Eklund, you ever see her naked?
When she gets out of the shower.
Yeah, and you get to see her naked and stuff? Do you think she's attractive?
I told you, Madonna's the one for me, no one else.
And your mom hit on you. I mean, not hit on you, but
what?
Hit on Rod Stewart, right? She was with Rod Stewart a long
time. Yeah, that's when I first moved here from London. We lived at his house.
You lived
so
at Rod's house?
So you had
house?
Rod Stewart for a dead, Peter Sellers for a dead, Rod Stewart for a dead, Slim Jim for
and Lou Adler's my stepdad now.
Really? Well,
and this is my nightclub. Wait, this is my
Lou
nightclub.
Lou Adler's your stepdad?
That's my nightclub.
And your nightclub is called On the Rocks.
Rocks.
And Jack Nicholson's door, did you get to meet all of Jack's cool friends?
Definitely.
Like when you're over there, who's some of the cool people you hang with?
Warren Beatty. Michael Douglas.
Michael Douglas?
Mm-hmm.
And, like, they treat you normal?
Yeah.
Wow.
They give her presents.
Do they really?
Yeah.
Nice.
Are you guys friends? Do you guys know each other?
Uh-huh.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. We're in a movie together that we just finished.
What's
she got
that?
Me the part.
What is it?
It's called Inevitable Grace.
Any of these stars ever talk about my show?
All the time.
No, sir, do they?
Yeah.
Really? Who have you heard talking about my show?
Everybody. My dad.
Your dad, Jack?
Yeah.
Jack,
what did he say?
What did he say?
I can't quote him.
Oh, what? Come on.
Everybody loves your show.
Really cool. All right. Well, yeah. I love you too.
I want to see Honey Melons.
Honey Melons?
The one that ate the banana with the whipped cream. And then French kissed the girl with
a
latex outfit.
She's going to be in my room later on if you'd like to come by.
I don't even remember that. What's she talking about?
And that's my club.
All right. Very good. Well, thank you. Very nice. The two girls, Victoria Sellers.
Thank you.
Peter Sellers' daughter. And, of course, Jennifer Nicholson, Jack's daughter. And they've lived confusing lives, but what the hell? And you actually look like Peter, and you look like Jack. Good for you. And you got some hot... Look at what Victoria's wearing. Jeez. You got any panties on there, honey? You wearing a thong?
Yeah,
she doesn't remember.
I don't wear a G-string. You get lost up there.
Okay. All right.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Nice meeting you. Say hi to Jack for me.
I will.
Bring him with you next time. Come on to be such a stranger. I don't think Mark Harris is turned on by either of those girls.
He was so confused by the Madonna comment. Somebody's interested in Madonna?
Really? All right, we're going to take a break. Gary, what's going on?
We're waiting for Ed Asner to get here. James Earl Jones hasn't called.
He's missing in action.
All right, we're going to get to James Earl Jones.
Baba Booey.
And there's just a lot of people here we got to meet. I want to meet some of our song parody winners and various people who might be performing tomorrow. I want to find out who these people are in the audience. We'll be back right after these words.
And Brian used to be the kings of L.A.
The champion of L.A. Radio shining star Howard Stern will be back with the funeral for Mark and Brainless in a moment.
It's Howard Stern in the morning on The Loop, AM 1000. Jim Shorts.
Well, your name is Uncle what?
Uncle Bobby O'Dell.
Yeah. You know your promotions department?
Yeah.
They sent up a picture of you.
Yeah.
What, somebody put a fire out with a shovel on your face?
Yeah, talk about the pot calling the kettle black.
What?
Bandage face, scab head.
You're an idiot.
Yeah, I'm an idiot.
You're an
Why
idiot.
Why can't you come on at 12:30
You're
and
an
do
idiot.
The sports like you said you were going to do?
Shut up.
Not once in the last week have you come on and done the sports right.
Hey.
What is that?
You suck.
Middays on AM 1000.
Hey.
Here I am again. Snapple has real... Look at this. I never stop. Isn't it great? Snapple has real brewed iced tea in 10 great-tasting flavors. Anybody I know who is an iced tea fan, and I know a lot of iced tea fans just in this building, they love this Snapple product. They have never tasted a better iced tea, Robin. And you know that's true. You've seen it for yourself, haven't you?
Absolutely. I have heard proof positive.
Yeah.
People addicted to Snapple iced tea.
By the way, let me tell you about the various iced teas that they have. They have the regular, the diet, the unsweetened, the decaffeinated, and the diet decaffeinated. They're all good. I mean, really good. And they have flavors like raspberry iced tea, diet raspberry iced tea, mint iced tea, peach iced tea, orange iced tea, regular iced tea, cranberry iced tea, and more. Please don't be fooled by the imitators. You see a lot of that going on. Snapple is America's favorite all-natural, real-brewed iced tea. That's not just a slogan. That's the truth. They're the number one selling iced tea.
Oh, I know it.
Snapple-ize your taste buds with Snapple's real-brewed iced tea, made from the best stuff on Earth.
And it's 10 minutes before 9 a.m. here in Chicago. 38 degrees at O'Hare. It's 40 at Midway. 40 degrees along the lakefront. Wendy Snyder here with these top stories. Governor Edgar is expected to announce his support for a third Chicago airport in Piatone. Edgar has scheduled a news conference for this morning. Meanwhile, a Las Vegas newspaper is reporting the governor might also support a casino in a rural area rather than in Chicago. And as Bill Clinton's Inauguration Day approaches, some of the official events are being announced. Barbara Streisand will be on hand to sing, although there's no word yet on where she'll perform, what she'll sing, or what she will wear. Weather-wise today, cloudy skies with patchy drizzle this morning, highs in the lower 40s. Jim, I can see what you're wearing today. You dressed up to do the traffic, huh?
As soon as there's word on what she's wearing, will you break in and tell us?
Yeah, we will do that. We'll keep you posted.
Big story. The Ryan inbound jammed up, 95th to downtown, 33 minutes. Stevenson, north south to Lakeshore Drive, 53 minutes. Cut it out. 33 from Harlem. The Ike inbound, 53 to the post office, about 55 minutes, so it's getting better. And back to 53, about 33 minutes. Kennedy inbound, O'Hare to downtown, 40, half hour from the junction. The express lane's very heavy, 16 minutes. At Division, an earlier stall is now on the side. Kennedy outbound, downtown to O'Hare, 25 minutes. I'm seeing all that movement, and you're throwing me off here. Edens, Lake Cook to Montrose, 19, and the same back to Lake Cook. The Callan, 57 northbound, 8094 to the Ryan, about 16 minutes, a good time. Lakeshore looks good both ways. The Tri-State northbound, Stevenson to the Kennedy, 25 minutes. At the north end of the mile-long bridge, there are gapers to a southbound accident. That southbound accident is at the north end of the mile-long bridge. A car hit the wall, and police are on the scene. The southbound Tri-State time from the Kennedy to the Stevenson, about 21 minutes. The other tollways look pretty good. Expect delays on the inbound Metro Electric Line trains. They're being stopped because of an earlier accident in Harvey when a train hit a pedestrian. This report brought to you by Continental Levitt Communications. Your dream come true, 150 minutes of Cellular One airtime free, plus a free accessory for your cellular phone. Only from Continental Levitt. Call 708-982-0220 for details. Jim Volkman, shadow traffic at 851. It's 851 on AM 1000.
Hello, Jack. Yeah, okay, look, LoJack, what is it that makes a car a popular theft target? You know, you're going to be surprised by this. It's not how expensive the car is or how beautiful the car is. It's how popular its parts are to unscrupulous body shops. I know, for example, Corvette is a very popular car to get stolen. And as your car ages, it may actually become more of a theft target. You see, people think it's only new cars. It's not. What happens a lot of time is the car ages. It's hard to get parts for these cars.
Well, that's what I was saying about the Corvette.
Yeah. In other words, Robin, the sum of the parts is more than the whole. Thank you. Good night, everybody. All right, look, here's the point. If your car is stolen and you have a LoJack in your car, the police can track it right down for you. If you're going to invest in a car, why don't you invest in a LoJack? At least you can keep that car, because when the insurance company gives you money back for your guitar, for your car, they only give you book value.
Call 1-800-27-LOJACK, 1-800-27-LOJACK now. Kev, Jonathan Brandmeier, Chet Kopic, Chicago Ed, the Blackhawks, and Fighting Illini, and Howard Stern in the morning. All on the Loop, your AM 1000.
Mark and Blockhead are dead. Yes. Long live the Czar of the Airwaves.
Oh, thank
Howard
you.
Stern.
Czar of the Airwaves, Rob.
Your yes. demigod, Czar.
Demigod.
We're running out of superlatives.
And we are here at Spago's. Yes, we are live in Los Angeles. Rob and I have remained sequestered for most of my trip here to Los Angeles.
Yes, you have been your room.
In my room, sequestered with the
having
lesbians.
Entertainment brought in.
Yes, I've actually treated myself like a true Roman conqueror. I've had lesbians up to my room
yes.
with the guys, and we enjoyed a big show. And then I had if this guy stands there and waves at me all day, Gary,
yeah,
it's really, just take him
that?
And punch him in the stomach.
All right,
thank you.
That's one of our clients.
I know.
I recognize him as the guy annoying you at the MTV Awards.
Yeah, well, have him move away, all right?
Yeah,
really.
You know,
he's just annoying me. He's annoying me. We have a sponsor here in Los Angeles who feels like he can annoy me whenever I come to Los Angeles. Who is that guy?
I think he's the guy that owns Cellular One.
Yeah, he's
okay.
obnoxious.
Okay,
don't you remember him from the MTV Awards
yeah.
the whole night?
Hey, Howard, interview me. I advertise on your show. I was like, get out of here.
Yeah, I remember him from that night.
Yeah.
Remember how I was just saying that none of our big celebrities have shown up?
Yeah.
Well, Ed Asner just got
oh,
here.
Good. Oh, good.
Wow.
I want to meet
you. Do you want to bring him right in?
Yeah, and there's also, I just want to remind people that, Jackie the Joke Man, tomorrow night, one big show at Chuckles in Mineola.
Yes, before we get to Ed Asner.
Yeah, I gotta get in his contractual plug. For info and dirty jokes, call the All Digital 516-922-Y. Next Wednesday, December 2nd at the Wilmington Comedy Cabaret in Wilmington, Delaware. Go try and stump the joke, man. Also, while we have a lot of guests here today and they're all coming down to celebrate with us our number one status before the big funeral tomorrow. Tomorrow is your funeral. Tomorrow, because you made us number one, the funeral we promised, the
That's
big
right.
funeral, the Roman Empire set is being erected right outside of, what's the name of that place?
The Palace Theater.
The Palace Theater on Hollywood and Vine.
I was going to say, you know, most times funerals aren't celebratory events.
Yes, but this one is.
Will
we have a Mark and Brian to, bury in a coffin?
Better.
What do we have?
We have a Mark and Brian that we will guillotine, and their heads squirt blood
Ooh.
For 7
Ooh.
Seconds.
And do I get to operate the guillotine?
I think so. I
Excellent.
Have to check.
All right, yeah, why don't you bring in Ed Asner? All right, here he is, Ed Asner. Another great celebrity who has stopped by to honor the king and
now,
queen of Los Angeles.
The president of SAG.
The
so,
president of the Screen
this,
Actors Guild.
This is...
Wow. Come on, a standing ovation.
Really
wow.
welcome.
All right.
How are you?
The president of one of my unions, as a matter of fact. I am a union member, Screen
and
Actors
so
Guild.
So am I, absolutely.
I've actually made $7 as a member of the
we
Screen Actors Guild.
We are the rank and file.
And here is our union president, El Presidente. Ed Asner, of course. Ed, honored to meet you, and I'd like to start off by having you say a few words on how happy you are to be with the king and queen of Los Angeles, the number one status. Tell the truth, when we came to Los Angeles, did you think we would hit number one in the ratings so fast?
Yes, certainly in L.A., because L.A. is a young town.
Right.
Young people are bedazzled by you.
They are, the young people.
Bedazzled?
But what about yourself? You're no spring chicken, Ed, as I may say. But,
But
he thinks
Don't let the voice and the face and the appearance fool you.
You're young at heart.
Yeah.
But the point is, are you fans of the Howard Stern Show?
Absolutely. I mean, you put me on the map, man.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
How did we do that?
Well, I had a brief encounter.
Oh, with Stuttering John. That's
right.
I forgot about that. You were great with Stuttering
How
John.
How is he?
Oh, he's great. Stuttering John, come say hi to Ed Asner.
He never calls. He never writes.
No, never.
And I...
Did you enjoy meeting Stuttering John? Was that a...
It was... It
you
was
were fabulous
thrill.
In that
it
interview. I mean, you had a sense of humor. You
well,
know what I mean?
Well, Stuttering gave it to me.
He absolutely did.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I'm sure you're going to want to smack Stuttering John when you see him. You're going to smack him in the head. Oh, didn't he annoy
it's
you?
It's all right with us.
No. He was very sweet.
Let me get down to it, Ed. The thing that I've always wanted to talk to you about is, before we get into how exciting it is that I'm number one, and the big funeral for Mark and Brain is tomorrow. And I know you're caught up in that whole competition.
But they've been dead a while, haven't they?
Yeah, they have been dead for a while. But the thing that I want to know is, did you ever get to French Kiss Mary Tyler Moore? Because I always felt on the show...
There was a tension.
I always felt that really, even though there was a tension on the show, I think in real life, Mary was sort of attracted to you. I could have seen you guys together as a couple.
Well, I often fantasized about it.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Did you fantasize when you were working with Mary Tyler Moore on the Mary Tyler Moore Show?
Oh, yeah.
And she was really at her height of beauty.
Yeah.
I mean, she was really beautiful.
Yes, she
well,
was.
Well, no, I don't buy the word height, but go ahead.
She was at the height, because she's not as beautiful now, I'm saying.
Well, in a different way she is.
Well, oh, you're too kind.
No, no, no,
no, no, no,
no. I really mean it.
You really
go
mean
ahead.
It? You're still attracted to her?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, he gets to see her, so.
Right.
I mean, he
mean, we would know.
Right.
But, I mean, she has grown in as an individual and character.
But working with her day in and day out, and I'm not kidding about this.
Yeah.
With that beautiful body, she had like a Barbie doll body. She has a very attractive personality, bright woman. I mean, you got along with her.
Right.
Were you sexually attracted to her?
Oh, immensely.
No, but I mean, you're being honest.
I'm being honest.
Well, why didn't anything ever happen?
Because she married that stupid doctor, right? You're better than him.
Because that impossibility of achievement is always much more interesting.
Is that right?
And you would think when you would go home from a day of work, you would sit and fantasize about it? Would you think about her at night?
Well, not every day.
No, not every day. But I mean, when guys...
Take a number.
All guys fantasize about women. Yeah. I know when I go home after a long day of work, because I'm in the radio industry, I get to meet many beautiful women. And when I lay down at night, my wife is not there. Yeah. I pleasure myself to thoughts of these women.
Okay. Yeah.
When you would
Do
come
you
home...
Do you have to disclose this to Ed Asner?
Why not?
Oh.
We're guys. Oh.
This is the first normal streak that he's admitted.
I know. I'm saying when you would work with Mary Tyler Moore, you would go home at night and you
would
think
about... Well, there was also Betty White and Georgia Engel.
Yeah, but you're not attracted to them.
And Rhoda.
Yeah, no.
And Phyllis.
Yeah. They didn't exactly get you aroused, am I correct? While they're very nice women, that's not right. Okay. You won't say it, but you'll nod your head yes. Okay. All right. I gotcha. So, in other words, you take the caviar, not the applesauce.
Any port in a storm is my move.
Right. No, but I'm saying, and also, when you were on the Mary Tyler Moore Show, I'm sure you could have gotten any woman you wanted. Are you married?
Not presently, but I have a lovely lady named Cindy.
Young?
Oh, well, she's younger than I am.
She is.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful model.
And she is, yes, well, of course she's young.
And she is? How old? How
I mean,
old
I would settle for nothing less.
Let me tell me, how old is she?
Oh, I'm not going to tell
Come
you.
On, tell me.
No,
tell me.
I wouldn't
tell me the truth. In her 30s?
Even if
she in her 30s?
No, she's not in her 30s.
In her 20s?
No.
40s?
Or in her teens.
Yes.
I don't know where we're going.
Be honest, is she out of high school?
Yes.
Yes, she is out of high school. Because
I'm going to adopt her next week.
It's got to be exciting for you because as popular a star as you are, you can get any woman you want.
No, that's
and it's
not
hard.
True.
It's hard to keep a marriage together. Was it hard to keep a marriage together during the Mary Tyler Moore years?
Yes, it was.
It was. You ended
up
in divorce.
How many times have you been married?
How many times have you been married?
Once.
One time.
Just once.
And you married you probably married this woman before you became a big celebrity.
Yes.
And what happened was you became a big celebrity. Women started throwing themselves at you, and you could not resist. Am I correct?
You know, to this day, I don't recall any woman ever throwing herself at me. I wish I had been aware of it at the time.
Is your girlfriend here?
Yes, she is.
She is. Is that her? Where is she? The woman with the boots on?
Yes.
That's her? Your Ed's girlfriend?
Oh!
Oh, my God. Oh, man. Whoa.
Thank you.
You are beautiful. Whoa. Hi.
Get out of the way, you bum.
What do you want me to say?
How long? Look at you. You're wearing mini skirt and thigh-high boots.
I am?
You're absolutely
yes, am.
Lovely. You're a beautiful woman.
Thank
now,
you
how
so
did
much.
You get Ed?
Way to go, Ed. How did you get Ed? That's a pretty good score. Ed's worth about $10, $15,
no,
$20 million. Oh, man.
That is so funny. That's good. That's rich.
Is Ed gonna put you through college? Oh, man. Look at you. Hubba hubba, Ed. But how do you come home and tell your wife, hey, listen, I got to leave
how
now.
How long were you married?
Right. I mean, right. Mary Schmary, I'd rather have you. Forget about Mary. Oh, Ed, you got the life, pal.
Okay.
But how long? Was it a long marriage?
How long were you married, Ed?
Not bad, huh?
Ed, how long were you married, seriously?
I was married from 1959 a lot of separation there.
17 years?
No, till 1987.
Whoa. And the point is, you meet a woman, you grow apart because you become this big star, and suddenly beautiful women like your girlfriend are throwing themselves at you.
She never threw herself at me.
How'd you meet Ed?
Mutual friends.
You would go to a party and they say, hey, we'd like to set you up with her. And you, of course, you used to watch the Mary Tyler Moore Show, true?
Indeed, I did.
And you said, oh, Ed Asner is really sexy. He's like a cuddly teddy bear, the whole thing.
I'd like
well,
to.
Well,
sure.
What is that, Robin?
I'm just saying, she must have said, I'd like to meet him.
And then, how long, and you fell in love with Ed immediately? Now, you must have watched the Mary Tyler Moore Show from your crib. Hey, how kind of thing is that?
Very nice.
Oh, yeah. She's
very
lovely.
Sweet.
You are a vision of loveliness.
Now, I seem to recall, don't you have young children?
Yes. Ed, you have young children?
I have a five-year-old.
You do? Ed, you're wilder than anybody I know on the planet. You're wild. You really are wild.
Thank you.
Are you sorry that you were controversial as the president of the Screen Actors Guild? Yeah.
No,
because I used to say, why is Ed Asner doing this to himself? Why does he just keep his mouth shut, continue to be the great actor that he is, and then and not get into these controversies because it could hurt you with work? Is that true?
It's true.
It is true.
Yes.
But you don't care. You're a man who takes a stand on things, and you
To go to El Salvador.
You had to go to El Salvador.
Oh, to tell you the truth, I've never been to El Salvador.
Is that right?
Really?
I've been to Nicaragua, but never to
Nicaragua.
I was warned not to go to El Salvador.
Do you meet girls on the picket lines when you're out protesting stuff and all that kind of stuff?
Oh, that's well, like Mark Lawrence said, that's why he joined the Communist Party, to meet broads.
Exactly. But Ed, this is an unbelievable life you're having. This is unbelievable what's going on. It's just the greatest thing in the world. And I want to really thank you for stopping by and saying, hey, Howard, you're number one. I appreciate it. And all this
I haven't
stuff.
Said that yet.
When are you going to say something?
Hey, by your mere presence.
I saw you on a Broadway play just recently, too, and you were good.
Did you see it?
Yeah, I went to see it.
You're one of the few.
I went to see it, and you were real good in it.
Thank you.
No one else in the cast was as good as you. Madeline Kahn was not even really up to it, to be honest
thank
with you.
You.
Yes, I think.
Go back to New York when you do, and tell Frank Rich that, won't you?
Oh, I absolutely would. Was Madeline Kahn a pain in the ass to work with, yes or no?
No.
On the Mary Tyler Moore Show, you know, all the guys on Mary Tyler Moore Show went wild. Gavin McLeod, he dumped his wife.
Right, yeah, you all got a little crazy.
You all got frisky. You all went nuts.
Yeah. But Ted and I didn't go nuts, he just died.
Yeah, Ted died. If Ted hadn't died, would he have gone nuts?
It was the pressure.
Yeah, right. But you're a great actor. And never mind acting schmacting. What's going on in your personal life could fill up volumes of books. It is unbelievable. You could write the book on how to get beautiful women. Are you gonna marry this woman?
I hope to.
You really do? When are you gonna pop the question? Come on, pop it right now on the show.
No.
Come on up. Ben has a question for you.
You may be number one.
Come on.
But you ain't getting all at number one.
Let me tell you something. Your autobiography is gonna be rated NC-17. You are very much in love with Ed?
Indeed.
You are?
Absolutely.
You are a very charming woman, I gotta tell you that. Ed wants to ask you a question right now, a very personal question. Go ahead, Ed. Go ahead, Ed. Ask the question.
Will you kiss me?
Oh, look at that. Yeah, I'll take a kiss too, I'll tell you that. So and you met Ed at the party, and it was love at first sight. And how long before the two of you became lovers, not friends? How long did it take?
Months.
Took you months to score with her?
Yes.
Is Ed the great lover that he says he is?
To me.
To you, he is. Is he the greatest man that you've ever had?
You know, you don't have to answer that. I refuse to let you answer.
Is twice in a row out of the question with Ed? Older you get, it's hard.
Now I'm getting into that age bracket you originally assigned me.
Yes, exactly. I'll tell you that. It is very exciting. When you go to parties, everyone goes, oh, look, Ed Asner. Is it exciting when you walk into the room with Ed?
Is for it me? Like,
yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And you have Hollywood friends? Are you famous yourself? Do you have some kind of fame?
Some kind of fame?
Yeah. Are you a famous?
She's a producer.
A producer? What do you produce?
I was associate producer on Sister Act.
Oh, really?
Oh.
Yeah. Mm. What about a new series with Ed? I like that idea. But, Ed, I am thinking of you for a role in Fart Man, my movie.
Good.
Which is being written by Jonathan.
I brought some of my material.
Did you really?
Yes.
What do you got?
Well, I don't... We're on the air.
Let me just say something. In the movie, I don't know if you're up for this, you play a gigolo.
Yeah.
Because it's going to reflect like your real life. You are constantly in bed with different women. It's
oh, good.
Yes.
Good. I think I'm up to it.
All right. I want to thank Ed Asner. Ed, are you excited about our number one status?
I am.
You really are.
And your queen?
Yes.
Well,
Robin Quivers.
Thank you for recognizing
me. No need to recognize Robin. Just me.
And I've got a son back there who's as tall as you.
Is that right?
Oh, what are you, 6'3"?
6'5". Hey. Your son, you will leave him a lot of money?
Yes.
You will? Mm-hmm. Oh, I wish you were my father.
But it takes my death to get to it.
It does?
Yes.
Oh. And you do not support your son in any way?
No.
You told him to go out and get his own job?
Right.
What does he do?
He pushes a push cart.
He just pushes a push cart.
He is a very talented rock musician.
He is.
Is that right?
Oh, you poor man. That sounds like you're supporting him.
Yeah, really?
No. Has his own band. He's a wonderful composer.
I see.
And they're going to hit it one of these days.
I see. And you have left him a very sizable amount of money? You're not after Ed for his money, are you?
He doesn't have any.
Oh, he doesn't?
No.
It's all going to my son.
You made millions, didn't you?
Didn't keep.
So. Really?
What did you do with the money, Ed?
Ask his wife.
Well, no.
She didn't get 50%?
No, she was not a grasping woman.
Really?
She's a wonderful woman.
I see. What did you do with all the money? Did you just go through it?
Yeah. No, but I didn't make the millions that you think I did.
Oh, you didn't?
Well, come on, you had your own TVs. You were on Mary Tyler Moore for many years.
I know,
in your own TV series.
That's true. Unfortunately, my profit on the own TV series was down the line, and when they killed it first run,
you didn't get
it
the
became
money.
Killed second run as well.
Is your son dating your girlfriend's sister? I'll tell you, that's wild. You are a lucky man.
My son be married.
Oh, he is married. All right, well, let me tell you something. That's a very fine relationship you got going there. You're a lucky man.
Thank you, Howard.
Ed Asner, continued success. You are a great star, a great actor, and I am an admirer of yours.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes, Ed Asner.
You're even bigger than 6'5 in my book.
Thank you, Ed. Thank you so much. And that is the great Ed Asner. We'll be back right after these words. Luke Perry is on the phone. Okay.
Now moving on up.
Los Angeles honors her successful media demigod. Howard Stern, king of all he surveys, will return after this.
AM 1000 with Howard Stern in the morning.
Their shirts are monogrammed. Their shoes are two-toned. They carry their balls in a bag. You know their names. These guys play for beer frames. Thursday, December 3rd at the Brunswick Northwest Bowl in Palatine. Bud Light, everything else is just a light. Fox 32 and AM 1000 presents the Kevin Matthews Bud Light Bowling Bash and live broadcast. To enter, send a postcard to Bud Light Bowling Bash, Box 1060 East Chestnut, Chicago 60611. Include your name, age, address, phone, and social security numbers. At this party, everyone gets to bowl. Plus, you'll have a shot at the $5,000 grand prize. Be the first to knock down the special Bud Light pin in the lead position to pick up a quick $5,000. There'll be plenty of great food provided by Brown's Chicken and Pasta. It tastes better. The Bud Light Bowling Bash and live broadcast with Kevin Matthews, Bruce Wolf, and the Midday Show. Thursday, December 3rd from 10 to 3. Keep it here for more details. From Bud Light's Everything Else is Just a Light, Box 32 and AM 1000.
You know, today, most everyone is looking for ways to make life a little easier, but you'd be amazed at how many people still sit in traffic shopping for a mattress when all they have to do is call Dial-A-Mattress toll-free at 1-800-MATTRES. You'd also be amazed that people wait days or even weeks for their mattress to be delivered when all they have to do is call 1-800-MATTRESS and have their mattress delivered within 2 hours and pay only upon approval. What's even more amazing is that people who shop in department stores may settle for any mattress instead of the quality name brands Dial-A-Mattress is famous for. Sealy Posturepedic, Serta Perfect Sleeper, and Simmons Beauty Rest. No obligation, no waiting, no problem. For over 10 years, Dial-A-Mattress has consistently given customers high-quality service at low prices. Call toll-free 1-800-MATTRES now. 1-800-MATTRESS and leave off the last S. That's the S for savings.
It's 11 minutes after 9 here in Chicago, 39 degrees at O'Hare, 41 at Midway, 41 degrees at the lakefront. Wendy Snyder here with these headlines. Several airlines have announced reduced holiday fares. America West has reduced fares as much as 30%, and that was quickly matched by United and American Airlines. And Woody Allen is refusing Mia Farrow's demand he sign an agreement in order to see their biological son, Satchel. The demands came after the four-year-old showed up at Allen's apartment for a visit while a crew from 60 Minutes was there. Meanwhile, Farrow has refused the television program's invitation to appear this Sunday to respond to Allen's comments Sunday night. And weather-wise today, cloudy with patchy drizzle this morning. We'll have highs in the low 40s. And now I think it's time to take a look at those roadways, Jim.
If you're ready, here we go. Kennedy inbound, O'Hare to downtown, 42. We're seeing some improvements. The express lanes, though, still heavy, 16 minutes from O'Hare to downtown. Outbound to O'Hare, about 22 minutes. That looks good. And the Ontario feeder past the Chicago River, an accident in the right lane. Eden's inbound, Lake Cook to Montrose, 19. And back to Lake Cook, about the same. The Ike inbound, 53 to the post office, down to 55 minutes. Back to 53. A half hour. The Stevenson north south of Lakeshore Drive, we're down to 53 minutes there. Ryan inbound 95 to downtown, about a half hour. Coming in on the Cal, 8094 to the Ryan, 16. Same for 57 northbound between 80 and the Ryan. Lakeshore Drive's fine in both directions. The tollway's not bad. However, the northwest tollway, eastbound Barrington Road to the Kennedy, the time is now 19 minutes, which is good. But on the Route 59 ramps at the northwest tollway, the signals are out, which is causing problems on the tollway and on Route 59. And a diesel fuel spill from earlier this morning, still causing problems in Sauk Village, southbound I-394 block at Steger Road. This report brought to you by Continental Levitt Communications. 150 minutes airtime free now from Continental Levitt when you sign up for a Cellular One airtime package. Call Continental for details. 708-982-0220. 972-0220. Jim Volkman, Shadow Traffic at 913 and AM 1000.
And Howard and Robin are in L.A. today for the funeral of Mark and Brian. Actually, the big funeral is tomorrow, but they're chatting with a bunch of celebrities this morning. And Howard said he was going to have Luke Perry on the phone, so we'll keep our fingers crossed and see what happens next on AM 1000. All right.
Service Merchandise presents Holiday Crisis at the Fergusons. Christmas is coming. Where will this hard-working family find the brand name gifts they need at rock-bottom prices?
Now get great savings on the full line of professional quality health-o-meter scales. It's the $1 million scale sale at Service Merchandise. These super accurate scales feature solid steel platforms and either speedometer style or electronic digital numbers. Health-o-meter Professional, now at great savings at Service Merchandise.
And now's the time to come to Service Merchandise for terrific savings on all Oneida products, including Treasure leaded crystal candlesticks, Oneida heirloom gold-accented stainless steel flatware, and Oneida Deluxe, Community, and heirloom stainless steel flatware. All are heavyweight, solid, and American-made. All at great savings at Service Merchandise. You won't believe the prices.
For the Service Merchandise store nearest you, call 1-800-251-1212.
Hockey in Vancouver has heard an AM 1000. Canucks 5, Blackhawks 2. Two scores plus an assist for Gino Adjic against Belfour. It was 5-0 before Larmer broke the shutout and his 14-game goalless slump. Coach Sutter was thinking about sitting Larms down, but the streak stays alive at 8:23. The Hawks 3 points behind Detroit, who blasted Tampa 10-5. They're off till Friday night at Edmonton. Greg Maddux and company have contacted the White Sox. And Monday Night Football, Washington gets an early field goal after a 19-play drive that took about 2 weeks. Then they don't score again at the Superdome. Saints win 20-3. New Orleans an underrated 8-3. The champs reeling. They're 6-5. They've lost 3 of 4. They've only scored 2 touchdowns in their last 23 quarters. Even the Bears are better than that. Tomorrow, the coach will announce Sunday starter Harbaugh or PT. Yeah, yesterday, the coach had praise for Will Fuhrer, and I say, play the rook. The Browns aren't sure their starter, either Tezak Philcox or Kozar, if he's ready. Earl Bruce fired his coach of Colorado State for creating, quote, a climate of fear and intimidation for his players. Here's Earl's response.
I can't believe it's going to be stuffed out by some guy by the name of Corey Johnson and Al Yates. I can't believe that. I don't want to believe that. Because all my life, no matter what I might think.
Young man, there's no need to feel down. I said, young man, pick yourself off the ground. I said, young man, cause you're in a new town. There's no need. Unhappy young man, there's a place you can go. I said, young man, when you're short on your dough, you can stay there, and I'm sure you will find many ways to have a good time. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. They have everything. It's fun to stay in the wild. someone came up to me and said, young man, take a walk up the street, it's a place there. Call the YMCA, they can start you back on your way. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. They have everything for your mental enjoy. You can hang out with all the boys. YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. Young man, there's no need to feel down. Young man,
periods. The Washington Redskins are having trouble scoring. It's now 2 touchdowns to 23 quarters after the Saints beat them 20-3 in ABC's Monday Night Football. As Frank Kipper would say, Washington had a 10-minute, 19-play opening drive, and they still only got a Lomer field goal. Early in Hilliard has the Saints scores. New Orleans 8-3, the Skins 6-5, and I like it when they struggle. Will it be PTR Harbaugh Sunday in Cleveland? The coach will make the decision tomorrow. Earl Bruce, the former Ohio State Buckeye coach, fired as coach of the Colorado State Rams yesterday for, quote, mentally and physically abusing his players. The coach didn't take it well.
I can't believe it's going to be snuffed out by some guy by the name of Corey Johnson and Al Yates. I can't believe that. I don't want to believe that.
Because all my life, no matter what I might think, has been devoted to football players. I would not damage a player at all. Ever.
The target of Bruce's anger, the athletic director at Colorado State. Basketball tonight, the Bulls go against Don Nelson's Warriors, 9-2. Rodman reinstated by the Pistons. That's the sports, 7:47. And I'm Jim Volkman.
To call the Howard Stern Show, phone 1-800-94-STERN. That's 1-800-947-8376. Or fax Howard at 212-759-KFAX.
Love me, Brian. Love me, Mark. Never let me go. Howard says
we beat you.
Suck.
No, we really blow.
Let's return to the funeral for Mark and Witless with the king of all radio empires, Howard Stern.
Two idiots who steal my material. They finally have gone down. We came to Los Angeles. They thought they were safe. You know, I never thought we'd get into Los Angeles radio. I never thought we'd actually find a station to put us on.
I know. We used to come out here, and we'd listen to the radio in the morning.
Yes.
And we'd cry because we knew we could beat these guys.
We knew we could beat them, but we were not being given the opportunity. And finally, we're here. We are here. We are number one. We have beaten those guys.
It's really sad.
Yes. All of Los Angeles rejoices. Rejoice. Number one, we will be out in front of the Palace Theater tomorrow. Also, one of the people who was good enough to be on our team, who used to say to us all the time, Robin,
who is this?
That if you guys were on in Los Angeles, you would kill. He even mentioned my name during the World Series, trying to get me a little publicity.
Yes.
The great Al Michaels of ABC Television.
ABC Sports.
You there, Al?
Howard, I told my wife a year ago, I said, if Howard is not number one by now, we're moving, because I don't want to live in a town where people are so stupid they don't understand that Howard should be number one.
You're too good to us.
The great Al Michaels. And Al, you always said to me, I used to say, you know, my dream is to get on in Los Angeles. After all, those two idiots. And Al used to say to me, those two idiots are ripping you off.
Yeah.
But I said it was really sad because we used to tell each other we knew we were better.
Right.
But so what?
Yeah,
they were still number one in Los Angeles.
After the show every day, Robin would go, you know, we're better than all these other guys. I go, yeah, but Rob, what are we going to do? I mean, what are we going to do? And Al Michaels, of course, you had always spread the word here in Los Angeles.
Howard, I feel like my mission has now been accomplished. I've been a missionary for a year. I mean, think about Los Angeles radio. Forget Mark and Brian. You've lapped them. They're gone. They're dead. The funeral is tomorrow. I went back. I did some research. Do you realize that 25 years ago today, the number one radio show in Los Angeles, honest to God, drum roll, please.
Go ahead, drum roll for Al Michaels. What's wrong with you guys? Fred, wake up.
The number one show was on KRLA, the Bob Eubank Show.
Oh, my God.
Bob Eubank?
You mean people had to suffer through the Bob Eubank Show? Is that what you're saying, Al?
Do you realize where civilization has come in a quarter century?
From the Bob Eubank Show to this. But, Al, I want to thank you for always being there to support us. This is Al. And believe me, Al has taken heat. He has gone to dinners with Kathy Lee and Giff.
And Giff, yeah.
And he's gotten yelled at for bringing my name up. He's been in all kinds of trouble.
Have you seen him lately?
Have you seen them? You've been having dinner with them lately?
I have to see him tonight. I'm trying to get Butt Mongo Fiesta on at halftime, but it's been a little difficult with Frank.
Oh, that's right. It is Monday night.
Hey, did you think it's kind of funny that Kathy Lee's going around doing all these interviews about her miscarriage? Al?
Yeah.
Don't you think that's kind of goofy? I mean, lots of women have miscarriage. It's not like she was in her eighth month. I mean, you know, it was like...
Howard, I'd rather talk about the Saints defense.
Come on, Al. Did you know she was pregnant at all?
Did you even know she was pregnant, Al? Because you're close friends of the family, right?
I see him every week.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I mean, and then she said, did you see that interview where she said she reached into the toilet to grab her baby back and stuff?
Yeah.
That's kind of weird, isn't it? All right, Al, never mind. All right, Al Michaels. By the way, Al.
Give our regards to Giff.
Guess who's here now to meet us personally?
If it's Wayne Gretzky, this is the most publicity he's gotten in 5 years.
Well, it is Wayne Gretzky.
How did you guess?
How did you guess? It really is Wayne Gretzky. Okay, Al.
Howard, I love you. You are the greatest. Godspeed. And forget those stupid, imbecile bureaucrats in Washington.
You're right. There he is, Al Michaels. The great Al Michaels. And now the great Wayne Gretzky.
The great one is here.
The great one. Hey, you know, I'm looking at him. He don't look that great. I bet you I can play hockey. You know, Wayne, I look at you and I go, hey, let me see what a great athlete looks like. And, you know, you don't look like anything special. I'm looking at Wayne Gretzky and I'm going, hey, maybe I could be a hockey player. He doesn't seem all that coordinated.
How are you guys doing today?
Wayne, Wayne, first of all, I want to thank you for showing up here. The great one, Wayne Gretzky, of course, who plays hockey. I have no idea who he plays
for. The Los Angeles Kings.
That's right. Only in America, Wayne, can you carry a stick and get broads and money. Isn't that true? Am I right? Do you always say
attacked.
That? You say, what is wrong with this stupid country? It is unbelievable, isn't it? When you were a kid and you had that stupid stick in your hand, and you're sitting there with the stick, and everyone's calling you a jerk for being there with the stick, and, you know, you're playing all right, but even your father probably said to you, you can't make any money doing this. Am I correct?
What, do you think you're going to be a pro?
Yeah. Oh, what do you think? You're going to be in the pros, you jerk, right? Is that what they said to you?
Yeah, they told me to forget about it. I was too small. There's no future in this. What are you doing? Go to school.
So what you're saying is, like me, when I came to Los Angeles and they said, you'll be on a 3-hour tape delay. You're broadcasting from New York. Los Angeles people will not like you because you're from... When they said all those things, I spit in their face. And what you're saying, as a kid, they told you you would never play professional hockey and you spit in their face. Am I correct?
Exactly.
Am I right?
Exactly.
Do you swear to tell the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help you God?
You got to love that. When they tell you you can't do it, you got to face right to them.
You face them. Exactly. You say F them, right? Say F them.
What are they saying now? F them.
What are they saying now, all those people?
They're telling me now I'm washed up.
Yeah.
No, I'm too old.
They were waiting.
No, I'm too old.
Now you're still playing hockey, right?
Yeah, but right now I'm hurt. But
you're hurt? So what's the matter with you?
You look okay to me.
Hey, you look fine. What's wrong with you?
We don't even really know. It's a disc problem in my upper back.
And your upper back right here?
Yeah.
I got the same damn thing.
You know, and you didn't even play hockey.
I didn't do anything. I took a karate lesson with my daughter, and now I'm all screwed up. I think you threw out your back with that beautiful wife of yours. That sexy wife you got.
Maybe that's what happened.
Oh, man. See, to me, the greatest thing about you being a hockey player is you got Janet Jones. Oh, man.
I would have to say that's probably the truth.
That is so lucky. When you were a kid growing up and everything, and, you know, you're a good-looking guy and everything, but you couldn't get Janet Jones caliber women, right? You know what I'm saying? You couldn't
Hey, listen, I can't even argue about that.
You can't,
right?
So when you became a famous hockey player, you started to meet Hollywood girls and models, right?
The one.
Oh, the one. Yeah, the one. You had a few before her, right?
Not as pretty as her.
Janet Jones, of course, her big movie was...
The Flamingo Kid.
But no, she had
She was in A Chorus Line.
A Chorus Line. I'm trying to think, though. There was a movie that I saw her in. Maybe it was a...
She's the athlete of the family.
She is the athlete. Oh, yeah. She was in a, like an Olympics movie.
Oh, that one with, what's his name?
and she's in a really tight leotard in that.
American Anthem.
Yeah,
right.
American Anthem.
That's it.
She's tight training. Leotard. She's training. What a movie this is. She was training.
See, now you know why I had to give up hockey. And
oh, man. What's it like? How do you meet a girl like that? Like, how did, like, tell me your love story there. So you're playing hockey and stuff. And then how do you meet Janet Jones?
How did I meet Janet? She's believe it or not, I met her at a basketball game.
At a basketball game. You were there as a fan, and everyone goes, hey, Janet, that's Wayne Gretzky. And Laker, she goes, who's that?
Lakers Celtic game. I had done a guest spot on a show that she was on a long time ago, Dance Fever.
Dance Fever.
I was a celebrity judge.
You were a celebrity judge on that?
I had absolutely no rhythm at all, and I came out to be a judge, and that's when we first met, 1981, I believe.
Hey, how much cash are you worth? You're like worth like $25 million.
Well, they gave him, all the money
that's
they
what
had
her mother
when he
told
came
her.
To Los Angeles.
Aren't you worth like, did you make her sign a prenuptial, Janet Jones?
Well, that's exactly what her mother told her.
Really?
Grab that man.
Yeah, she said, hey, you can fall in love with that guy.
It's exactly what happened. No. Anyway, we met in 81, and we didn't see
each other. So wait a second. You go to this game, and she's, what does she do? Does she reach into the popcorn box that you had? Huh?
No, we went to the game separately.
Oh, separately. And what was she wearing? Was she wearing a mini
tight
skirt?
Jeans.
Tight jeans.
She looked great.
Tight jeans.
I'm not, even though I'm a hockey player, I'm not stupid.
All right, I know. So she's wearing tight jeans and stuff, and you turn to her and you say, hey, would you go out with me?
Exactly.
And she goes, sure, I'd love to go on a date with you.
Yeah, and we went on a whirlwind tour for about 2 months.
How long does it take you before you start making love? Like, do you have to wait, like, weeks, or do you get it that night?
No, I don't think you have to wait weeks, but you don't get it that night.
You didn't get it that night?
No.
You didn't?
No, but it wasn't weeks. I mean, come on, Howard.
Were you going nuts? You were probably like, oh, man, I got to get her. Like, you had, like, fever. You had love fever.
Exactly. And but it was a two-way street. She did too, I'm sure.
All right. So you meet her when you did the judging for that Dance Fever.
Yeah. Oh, that was in 81. Though.
And that had to be a low point in your career when you had to judge Dance Fever, right? The Jenny Terrios.
What was that all about?
Right. And she was also judging, right?
It was a low point because I had no rhythm and I had to come out and dance.
Yeah, I mean, who are you to judge people?
It
you know
was
what
awful.
I mean?
I was very bad, believe me. And then
now, when you meet a woman like Janet Jones, now what I do is I have a bunch of 50s hanging from my hat. I wear a little hat and I have a bunch of $50 bills hanging from there.
But I did too, but they were Canadians. They're only worth $30.
I see your Canadian money.
Yeah, it wasn't
all right,
very
wait
good.
A second. The great Wayne Gretzky.
Now,
here.
A lot of people said she stole you from Canada. Now, is that true?
Oh, screw that. Listen, Wayne,
thank you,
hold on. We'll get back to your exciting love story. Let me take a short break
all
here,
right.
Wayne.
Okay.
When we come back, I want to learn about the first night, how you scored, and when you scored, how many times you scored. And I don't care. I'm not talking hockey now.
Was it your greatest score?
Was this your greatest score in history?
Okay.
And do you get tired of scoring?
We'll talk about it after
all right,
break.
After the break, we'll be back with the great one, Wayne Gretzky. We're going to talk about his hat trick with Janet Jones.
Ain't gonna pay no dirty stinking fine. I got my rights, this is asinine.
We'll be back with Howard Stern's funeral for Mark and Bonehead after this.
It's Howard Stern in the morning on The Loop, AM 1000.
The tradition continues, this time on a whole new frequency. It's the Chicago Eddie Schwartz Good Neighbor Food Drive and live broadcast to benefit the Chicago Anti-Hunger Federation.
I want you to mark Friday night, December 11th, in your calendar as a very important night. It's the night of our Loop, AM 1000 Good Neighbor Food Drive. And we need you there.
Eddie will be across from Daly Plaza on Clark Street between Washington and Randolph. For more information and to volunteer to help, call 708-474-FOOD, 708-474-3663. And send your donations to Good Neighbor Food Drive, Box AM 1000, 60 East Chestnut, Chicago, 60611. Let's join Eddie. Bring lots of food and make this year's food drive the biggest yet. The Good Neighbor Food Drive.
We'll be there broadcasting.
With Eddie Schwartz to benefit the Chicago Anti-Hunger Federation. Brought to you by WLUP Chicago, your AM 1000.
Service merchandise presents Holiday Crisis at the Fergusons. Christmas is coming. Where will this hardworking family find the brand name gifts they need at rock bottom prices?
When every penny counts, shop at Service Merchandise. Hurry in now and get the Lady Remington Wet Dry Cordless Shaver for just $19.96. A foil top and stainless steel cutters provide close, comfortable shaving every time. And it all runs on two AA batteries. The Lady Remington Wet Dry Cordless Shaver. Thanksgiving week sale price $19.96 at Service Merchandise.
And look for the Remington Microscreen Cord Shaver. Now at Service Merchandise for just $29.92. Two thin microscreens with 120 cutting edges provide a remarkably good shave. Ergonomic design means it's comfortable to hold and easy to use. The Remington Microscreen Cord Shaver with travel case. Thanksgiving week sale price $29.92 at Service Merchandise. So hurry in.
For the Service Merchandise store nearest you, call 1-800-251-1212.
And it's 1 minute before 8 a.m. here on the Loop, WLUP Chicago, AM 1000. 37 degrees at O'Hare. It's 40 at Midway, 40 degrees at the lakefront as well. Wendy Snyder here with these headlines. CTA riders will be paying more for service next year, but it is still not known if service will be cut. CTA President Robert Belcaster is asking the CTA board to approve a large increase in the price of monthly passes and slight increases in tokens and off-peak bus fares. And even though the name is the same, today's marijuana is stronger and more dangerous than the pots of two decades ago. Officials with the U.S. Drug Enforcement Agency say marijuana is now 10 times as strong as it was in the 60s. They say a slightly different, unfertilized type of marijuana plant is being harvested and sold. The marijuana being sold today has THC levels of 18 to 19% compared to 1 to 3% 20 years ago. Don't smoke and drive.
That's right. Things getting better on the Kennedy. O'Hare to downtown, 35 minutes. 14 in the express lanes. At Ohio, though, there's an accident. Kennedy outbound, downtown to Montrose, 21 into O'Hare, 33. So we're seeing improvement there. Eden's Lake Cook to Montrose, 21. And outbound back to Lake Cook, about 24. The Ike inbound, 53 to the post office. About an hour four at this point. Back the post office to Route 53, 45 minutes. Stevenson north south to Lakeshore Drive, an hour 10, 40 minutes from Harlem. The Ryan, 95th to downtown, 40 minutes. At 18th Street, an accident in the right center lane. Coming in on the Cal and 57 northbound, about 27 minutes from 80 to the Ryan. Lakeshore Drive, the exit to Belmont and the Belmont entrance to the southbound drive. There's a problem there with the lights out and stop signs are posted. Lakeshore northbound is good. Marquette to Monroe, 16 minutes. Tri-State northbound, Stevenson to the Kennedy, about 25 minutes. The other tollway is pretty good, but the Northwest Tollway eastbound, Barrington Road to the Kennedy, down a bit to about a half hour, but the around 59 ramps, the Northwest Tollway, have their signals out. And there's a diesel fuel spill in Sauk Village, southbound I-394, blocked at Steger Road. This report brought to you by Illinois Vehicle Insurance. Auto insurance, it's the law in Illinois. For low down payments, special rates for teens, and the lowest rates available, call 312-736-2242, Illinois Vehicle Insurance. Jim Volkman, Shadow Traffic at 801 on AM 1000.
When you pour 120 of America's great beers together, one rises to the top. Samuel Adams Lager. That's what's happened for 3 years running at the Great American Beer Festival, where 5,000 brewers and beer lovers voted Samuel Adams the best beer in America. In fact, Samuel Adams is the only beer voted the best beer in America 3 years in a row. I'm Jim Cook, and I think the way I brew Samuel Adams makes it the best beer. I craft brew it using nothing but classic, honest ingredients. Pure water, lager yeast, two-row malt, and Bavarian hops. That's all. Samuel Adams is so pure, it passes Germany's strict beer purity law. And its rich lager taste is why Samuel Adams is the only American beer imported into Germany. So you can drink what you're drinking now and be a good beer drinker. Or you can drink Samuel Adams and be America's best beer drinker.
Hi, Tom Carey here at Hawthorne Racecourse, where for three generations my family's been involved in every aspect of racing.
Oh, Mr. Carey, can you help me up on my horse?
There you go.
Thanks.
See, my family's worked really hard to create a world-class racing facility, one you can enjoy year-round with a modern, climate-controlled grandstand and a panorama. We have four great dining facilities, one of the country's longest, most exciting home stretches.
Mr. Carey, can you watch Bernadette?
I'll be back in a sec.
Sure. What was I saying?
Your non-winning Jumping Jack Cash Instant Illinois Lottery ticket is good for a free weekday admission to Hawthorne Racecourse. Look for details at participating 7-Elevens, where you can also register to win one of 12 domestic round trips for two on United Airlines, Chicago's hometown airline. No purchase necessary. Restrictions apply.
Yes, Bernadette. That's my microphone. No, Bernadette, don't.
Get on the right track at Hawthorne. On Cicero and Laramie, between the Eisenhower and Stevenson Expressways. Post time, 1 p.m.
If injured and need legal help, you want the injury lawyers. The Briskman Brothers. On your side, every step of the way. Call them at 222-0309. That's 222-0309. Call now.
Kevin Matthews and Jimmy Shorts. Right after Howard Stern in the morning. On the Loop, your AM 1000.
And today's weather forecast, cloudy skies with patchy drizzle this morning. We'll have highs in the low 40s. Tonight, rain likely toward morning, low around 40. And Wednesday, rain, windy, and chilly with highs in the lower 40s. And at 8:04, it's 37 degrees at O'Hare. I'm Wendy Snyder, and it's the funeral of Mark and Brian today. Live from Los Angeles, it's Howard Stern on the Loop AM 1000.
Get out of town.
You are two dumb bitches, Mark and Brian.
Yes.
You are two dumb bitches. Howard's number one.
L.A. worships at Howard Stern's feet.
No.
The funeral for Mark and Stupid. Once again, media wizard
so
Howard
funny.
Stern.
I know. All right, we're here with the great one, Wayne Gretzky. They call you the great one, right?
Yeah, I used to be.
You love that. What do you mean you used to? So what? You were great.
So you hurt now.
So big deal. Your arm hurts.
Yeah,
what, in your back? It's in your upper back and you can't skate like that?
It's in my upper back. I haven't done anything. This is the first time in my whole life that I've had to watch my weight. I have a little bit of a weight problem right now.
Boy, because you're not exercising.
Because I haven't done anything in 12 weeks, but, hopefully this...
And is there pressure for you to get out there? Because Janet's like, hey, Wayne, come on.
It's funny how things happened. She got blamed that we got traded to L.A. Everybody said she was like Yoko Ono. She broke
right, she took beat. Him away.
Took him away.
And now the big thing around town was that I was going to have surgery, but Janet wouldn't let me, so...
Oh, really?
Oh, dear.
She doesn't boss you around, right?
Janet takes all the abuse.
Let me tell you something. You know, your back might hurt, and you might be a little injured. But I'll tell you something, you're rich, and you can still get aroused, so you're fine as far as I'm concerned.
And he's a hockey player, and you have your teeth.
Yeah.
No, I know. These are all fake.
Oh,
you're
those are fake?
Yeah.
You mean all your teeth have been out?
Oh, yeah.
See, those are fake teeth?
Yeah.
Hey, you got a good job.
Yeah,
hey, Gary. Hey, Baba Booey, you ought to take a look at Wayne's teeth. They're a lot better than yours.
I grew up, and I had braces, and just after I had my braces taken off, I got all my teeth knocked out.
Oh, jeez. Oh,
yeah, I made my parents
I love that
happy.
Game, hockey.
Yeah, it's too weird. All right, Wayne, listen, we're running out of time, and I want to get to all the Janet Jones question. All right, so all of a sudden you're there, and you go out on a date with her,
mm-hmm.
and then she doesn't give in to you on the first date because you're the great one, Wayne Gretzky. I mean, she probably was just as curious to find out what you were all about.
I think that it was, for me, I don't know, but for her.
Second date you scored?
I have to let her talk.
First date you scored?
No, but I was in love the first date. I knew it was going to be...
You knew it was love?
I knew it was love.
Yeah, but of course
it's
love. But you got to say something.
What's not to love?
You got to be physical.
Exactly.
Yeah, right. How could you not be in love with that?
You're exactly right. I mean, all I can say is that, it was great.
And then you had her that, like, the first or second night of the date, right?
Okay, we'll go with that.
Where'd you go on a date? You went out to a restaurant?
Yeah.
And everyone was going, ooh, Wayne Gretzky, right? So that's good.
No,
that gets her all hot.
No, because in L.A. we went out for dinner. Nobody knew who Wayne Gretzky was. They had no idea.
All right.
I mean, it was like, who's that guy with her?
And what did you do? Like, did you start holding her hand the first date?
Oh, yeah.
You did?
Yeah, yeah.
You put your arm around her and stuff?
Sure. You know, rubbing the feet under the table.
Oh, you did all that? And you started kissing her and everything?
Yeah. Did I say kissing her? Maybe I tried to. She probably wouldn't let me, but I tried. Yeah.
And then you start getting her and everything. And then you decide to marry her. But you're the great one, Wayne Gretzky. You got all this money. You say, hey, maybe she's marrying me for my money, right? Maybe she doesn't really love me. How did you know?
I didn't.
You didn't.
I still don't.
Doesn't know.
He took a gamble.
Three kids later, I'm right into this. I've got no way out now.
That's it.
You guys have three kids?
Yeah, we just had a third, 8 weeks old.
Well, that means she probably loves you. Yeah, I think so. When she starts having your kids, that means she loves you.
Come on, Howard. Where did you grow up?
I feel pretty good about my instincts about people, and I feel pretty good. Hey,
but in the beginning, like when you first started dating, did you ever accidentally like catch her reading your checkbook or something?
Going through it?
Going through your checkbook and like seeing how much money you actually had? You did catch her doing that.
Missing my credit card?
Yeah, I thought so. and you and Janet listen to the show?
Yes, we do.
And when you make love to her, though,
But listen, my daughter's four. Is that too young?
No, that's fine. I think that's being a responsible.
Because my wife always says, you know, you shouldn't let her listen to their show. I said, well, we'll give them one more year.
Yeah, it's all right. Don't worry about it. Nothing bad will happen to her. Believe me.
All right.
Lots of kids listen to this
show,
don't they, Robin? But you know what? So would you ever get tired of, like, being with Janet Jones? I mean, when you're with someone that cute?
I guess not.
Really? And you never do? Like, it's always a great experience.
I think I got to worry more about her than...
Because she goes out and does acting stuff, and then...
No, she hasn't. She just had her third baby.
And you don't let her go act?
Barefoot and pregnant for 4 years.
You don't want her acting anymore.
I was going to say, I don't think they've been married that long. They have three kids.
Yeah, you've been pretty busy. So she stays at home with you all day, and then what do you guys do? Just hang out? Because you got all kinds of money and stuff.
No, she doesn't
Well, how does she prepare you for a game?
They got this road called Rodeo drive here.
Yeah. You go there,
so she's been doing hard time over there.
Yeah, hard time.
And what do you do all day? I mean, you just hang out?
What do you do all day? We have three kids.
Yeah, but I mean,
let me tell you, I can't wait to play hockey because it's so much easier. My hat goes off.
He's got to get out of the house.
Yeah, right. Yeah, you want to get away from those kids. But I want to thank the great Wayne Gretzky for coming. He is a big fan of ours.
Yes.
Listen to the show all the time.
Listens to the show every day. He wanted to come by and thank us for being in Los Angeles. Congratulations.
Well, thank you.
Good luck to you guys.
Yeah, and thanks for coming on. The great one, Wayne Gretzky.
Yes.
And Janet Jones. Give my love to Janet.
I will.
All right, Wayne. Take off those headphones or else you'll be really injured. You look fine, believe me. You'll be all right. I'm going to heal you. I'm going to heal you. Don't worry about it. Tomorrow you're going to wake up, you're going to be 100%. Hey, as long as you can get it up, I don't care.
Oh,
then you're fine.
You're not injured, huh?
Yeah, he's not injured. Robin, there are so many celebrities waiting to get in here.
Yes?
It is so exciting.
They're backed up, the celebrities?
You know, when you become number one in Chicago or Albany or Philadelphia, of course it's exciting, but nothing is as exciting as the show business community embracing you, and that is exactly what's happening. Here's Baba Booey with the report on what's going on. Baba Booey, tell us about the excitement outside of Spago's. There are many people with us.
Okay, waiting on hold is everybody's famous's child in the world.
Famous's?
What?
Famous's. What? Famous children.
Waiting on hold.
He just made a sentence.
Waiting on hold
is everybody's famous assistant.
I got nervous. I sounded like Gorilla for a minute.
All right, start again.
Baba Booey.
Waiting outside to come on the show are very famous children of very famous people.
Are children of famous people.
But now they're famous themselves as well.
Is that right?
Tori Spelling is famous.
Hey, let me ask you something. Did you ever play hockey, Baba Booey?
Did you get hit in the head with a puck?
Did you get hit in the teeth?
Yes.
All right. And,
okay, well, Tori Spelling is here. She's looking incredibly cute.
Tori Spelling, of course, the star of Beverly Hills 90210, but more importantly, her father is Aaron Spelling.
That's right. The daughter of...
Right, the daughter of Aaron Spelling. Did he come by with her?
No, he didn't.
He didn't?
No.
Well, maybe we can call him.
Yeah, maybe today he'll...
We got a phone here?
Sure.
Okay.
Okay, right. Also we have Melissa, is it Rivers now?
Yes.
Melissa Rivers.
Melissa Rosenberg. Out of respect to Edgar, I call her Melissa Rosenberg.
You're still calling her
Missy.
Rosenberg.
Missy.
Joan calls her Missy.
Yes, Missy.
Missy. And
we also have Jennifer Nicholson and Victoria Sellers.
Oh, first bring in Tori and Melissa.
Okay.
All right, and then we'll get to Jennifer Nicholson is Jack Nicholson's daughter, but...
And Victoria is Peter Sellers?
Yeah, Peter Sellers' daughter.
Uh-huh.
It'll be weird being known as somebody's daughter.
Well.
There's Tori. Let me soak that in. Baba Booey, get out of my way so I can see the outfit. nice body. Man, thinner than ever.
How did she get that thing?
And there's Melissa. Hey, Melissa, how you doing? Hey, now, do you guys know each other? Tori, you know Melissa Rivers?
No, hi.
Hey, sit down, Tori. Oh, Tori's all freaked out. I thought I was alone. Hey, Melissa, how you doing?
Good, Howard. How are you?
Good you're not here with your mom.
She's working.
Yeah. Well, when Melissa's here with her mom, I can't ask her about her sex life. Tori, nice low-cut top.
Thank you.
All right. Looking good. Of course, you're on Beverly Hills 90210, but man, what a shot on your breast.
Whoa.
Hey, Melissa, you should dress more like Tori. I'm serious. You covered up too much.
It was there.
Yeah, just take off your shirt. I'm telling you right now.
Oh, my goodness.
Man, I can see your whole cleavage.
It is not that low cut.
Yeah, it really is. Are you wearing a bra?
Yes.
Oh, you are? Is your dad listening this morning?
Yes.
Why don't you call him? Get him on the phone. I want to talk to him.
No.
Call him up. Call up Aaron Spelling.
Did you ask him to come with you?
Did you ask him to come with you? Or are you trying to get away from him?
I wanted to do the show.
You want to do the show.
Here.
Oh, yeah? Look at Tori, man. Look at that top. See, Melissa, I can't even concentrate on you now because you're not wearing a sexy top.
I'll cover it.
Isn't this exciting that we are number one in Los Angeles and we're here? The big funeral is tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Will you be coming to the funeral, Tori, as well? Will you be there to see it?
I'm working.
You're working tomorrow morning?
Well, you know, they'll let you off.
Yeah. You're working. Yeah. Her father might make her work.
So your father's... I always get the special treatment. Just kidding.
And Melissa, your mother, of course, is Joan Rivers.
Yes.
We have to always mention that.
Of course.
Because Tori's father's Aaron, and your mother's Joan Rivers. That's real good.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, what was it? So Robin taped the Joan Rivers show the other day.
Okay.
And then all of a sudden she started saying that, what did Joan say?
Well, Joan told the audience that you had once had a boyfriend
who beat you?
Why does she do this to me?
Can you believe that? I said to Robin, why does she make those announcements?
That was exactly what Howard
said. Ask me if she cleared it with me. No.
That's your life.
Exactly.
Why would she do that?
Because she's my mother.
And she just...
just blurts it out?
Yeah, Joan doesn't say anything about people who beat her.
No.
She just, was it weird the other day when your mom was talking about her sex life in front of you?
It made me crazy. I can't handle talking about their sex life.
Yeah?
Who could handle that?
Ugh.
You know how weird that is? Hear about your mom having sex with old guys? It's unbelievable. And are you wearing a long-sleeve shirt today because you're black and blue?
No.
From being beaten? What happened? You were beaten by some guy?
I don't want to talk about
it. No, yes, you do. You're going to talk about
it.
If you don't, I'll start talking to Tori immediately. This is your one big chance.
No, I dated a guy who had a substance abuse problem at one point in his life, and I said he had to go into rehab, and he sort of flipped out at me. And that's not why I'm wearing a long-sleeve shirt.
So you said to him, hey, you better go into rehab.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, he just started beating you?
He just lost it.
He beat you?
Yeah.
That son of a bitch. Give me his name. I'll go have Gary kick his ass. No kidding.
Swear to God.
And you called your mother and you told her?
Yeah.
And she goes and blabs it to the whole world.
She immediately came and told us.
You can't tell your mother anything.
It was about 5 years ago.
You have learned not to tell your mother anything, right?
I tell my mother nothing.
Yeah, because she tells... She
nothing.
And this was not even on the show. This was in the audience break.
In the middle of a break.
She goes, do the impression of Jones.
She goes... And the funniest part was that she was talking to the people who were on the show. You know, we're just having a little conversation. And then she got to the part where she wanted to talk about you.
Oh, God.
And what happened to you. She leaves us, turns to the audience, goes, yes, my daughter Melissa, she was beaten. She called me out from Los Angeles. She was in school.
I'm going to kill her.
That was unbelievable.
Can we get her on the phone?
And she did it.
It's the killer. She starts telling the audience.
You get her on the phone, Gary.
I'm going to kill her.
You can yell at her. This is good. I love when kids yell at their moms. I tell you, now she's going to owe you because now you have a reason to be mad at her. Now she'll send you more money.
No, now I know what I want for
Tori,
Christmas.
Tori, answer for real this time. How much does your dad, Aaron Spelling, why are we getting Joan on the phone? How much money does your dad give you as an allowance?
I don't get an allowance.
Well, how much did you get as a kid?
$5.
No, be honest.
No,
be honest.
Swear.
That's not true.
No,
yeah, you're lying now. Tell the truth. Your father is a billionaire.
I swear.
Your father's a billionaire. Hey,
yes.
Do me a favor. Could we go over your house later?
Or could we have...
could Stuttering John spend the night there? Could Stuttering John spend the night at your house and then, like, come back and report on it?
Come on!
How many square feet is your house?
I do not know.
How many square feet? You know.
No, I don't. I don't keep track of that.
Who's the president of the United States? All right, there you go.
Clinton. It's big. It's huge.
Because even Melissa, like, her mom gave her tons of money. Like, she goes, I bought my car is a Porsche. I bought it with my own money.
I did have...
You're a production assistant.
I'm not a production assistant.
You were a production assistant when you bought the Porsche.
No, I wasn't.
What were you?
I was already on MTV at that point.
Yeah, but how much could they have been paying you?
I had already worked for 2.5 years, putting it away and investing it wisely, as my father taught me to do.
Oh, no. I don't buy that for a minute. I don't care how smart of an investor you are. You had trust funds and stuff, and that's how you got the Porsche.
I buy it.
Yeah, and Tori's got a BMW.
Yeah.
And you didn't pay for that yourself.
No, I didn't. I got it when I was 16.
You got it when you were 16.
I have the same car. I haven't...
I'm telling you, if I wasn't married, I would court you, I'd marry you, and you would be my wife, and that would be it. And I don't want to hear about it. Even if you didn't like me, you'd marry me.
That's right. You'd have to. He'd force you.
You live in a giant-sized mansion, the biggest mansion in Hollywood, right?
Yes.
And can John spend the night there tonight? Stuttering John, come here. Come here. Talk to Tori.
Would you like to stay in my basement tonight?
No, seriously. Can you sleep over?
In one of the rooms? Is all right?
Basement?
All right, I'll stay in the basement.
Can he stay over?
I'm sure
can John sleep over tonight?
Come on.
You gonna call my dad and ask?
Yeah, I'll call him up. I'm gonna call him and ask.
Seriously, Tori, how come John can't spend the night there?
He doesn't let strange guys spend the night.
He won't? But I don't mean sleep in your bed. I mean, can he have one of the guest rooms?
He's not coming home to sleep with you.
Could you have a special wing for guests?
No. I mean, we have a guest room.
I'll be clean.
That's fine.
Yeah, you know, just have John.
Joan's on the phone? All right, Joan's on the phone. Joan? Joan? Boy, this is some show. It's a lot heating up here.
Really?
We'll get John into Tori's house.
Okay.
Hey, Joan?
Are you coming to my Christmas party, yes or no?
No.
Okay.
Last year, your Christmas party was terrible. The biggest celebrity you had there was Cindy Adams.
Are we back to that, Howard?
You didn't even have any good celebrities at your Christmas party.
What about Robin?
Well, we got to meet me. That's
I get to
true.
See Robin all the time.
Robin.
We go over to Joan River's house, and I never go to parties, but I said, this is going to be
we
cool.
We got to do this. This will be cool.
This will be our first big party with, like, celebrities and stuff. We go over there, and... Cindy Adams and Joey Adams are the toast of the town.
I remember that you had a very good time.
New York society.
I didn't have a good
problems.
Time. Tori, you must have some...
New York society.
Hey, you know who's here with me, Joan? Tori Spelling and your daughter.
Oh, Mike, which one is my daughter?
Tori's dad is Aaron Spelling.
Yes, I know. I'm trying to get
as in,
loan.
As in the billionaire?
Yes, I know.
Yeah, and we're going to sleep over our house tonight.
That's good, because nobody will find you.
Now, listen, Joan.
Yes?
We've just been talking to Melissa, and we broke the news
to
her.
Hello.
Hi, Mom.
I haven't spoken to you in 3 days. Don't start with me.
She's real mad at you.
Excuse me?
She's mad at you.
Because?
Because when Robin was taping your show,
yeah,
you got up during the break, and you started talking about how Melissa was beaten by a boyfriend.
Yeah.
So Melissa freaked out because you're not supposed to be telling those stories.
I didn't give names, Melissa. I didn't give years. I said how proud I was of you because.
But how can she trust you?
Time.
How can she trust you if you're going to every time
Mom.
She confides in you?
Melissa suddenly wants a private life.
Mom. Yeah, but that's not your story.
Melissa Rosenberg, when she was born, they had a camera in the room with us.
Hey, Joan, Melissa's giving you the finger right now. I'm not kidding.
No, I'm not, Mom.
Flipping you the bird.
I am not.
That's fine.
But I am not. Mom, I can't believe you said that, though.
I didn't give names, and I said
how proud I was that you went back at that early age. You knew enough not to go back.
Yeah, but why?
Mom!
Yeah, but Melissa, tell her what you were just telling us. She's embarrassed that this is not your story to tell. That's Melissa's story.
I'm able to tell Melissa something about herself that she doesn't know I know, Joan.
When Melissa calls you in confidence and says, hey, I just got finished getting beaten up by my boyfriend, you're not supposed to go blab that all over the place.
No, the point was at 17, she said, I'm not going back, and that's great.
Well, I understand your...
And you didn't press charges, Joan?
And that's a smart kid. No.
How
what
come?
What we did is we put him away and we paid for it.
You put him in rehab and paid for it?
Because he's from
his family,
and then his family took over.
And how bad did he beat you up?
Not that bad, thank God.
Joan, you didn't get beat up. I'm asking Melissa.
You'd think it was Joan's story. Listen to her.
By the way, Robin, tell Melissa how Joan described to us at the Christmas party Melissa's first period. Was wild. Joan.
Yeah, I didn't want to bring that up.
Hey, Joan, you want to share that with us? All right, Joan. Joan, you can now congratulate me on my number one status in L.A. and wish me luck at the funeral tomorrow.
I love you. I adore you. And if they don't want to listen to you, turn the dial. Leave us alone already. I'm so bored with them telling you what you're supposed to say and not say.
All right. Thank you, Joan.
I love you. Speak to you.
Love you.
Howard.
Melissa, I'd have sex with your mother. Isn't that sick?
Tomorrow, a Wednesday, you got to watch the Jessica Hahn thing on my show.
Yes,
oh,
I will.
Wednesday?
Yes, we will.
That little tramp is on. Wait till you see it.
Oh, boy.
Bye, Mom.
Did you have sex?
Call one day, Melissa, between now and Shavuot.
Hey, Joan. Did you have sex last night?
Melissa knows. Three in a bed.
All right. Very good, Joan.
Goodbye,
Bye, Mom.
Goodbye, Jory. The show was adorable that you were on.
She is adorable. And she's wearing a low-cut top. I can see almost all her whole breast.
Yeah, and is Robin in her leather?
No. Hey, I tell you, if I was single, I'd marry Tori. I would, you know, Melissa's okay because she only has so much money.
Well, you know, you have said at times you would marry Melissa.
Yeah, but now I'm into Tori. Now I'm much more into Tori because she has more money.
If Tori would take me, I'd marry you too.
Tori, you're sexually interested in me, aren't you?
I'm going to get off.
All right, goodbye, Joan.
Bye, Mom.
Bye, Melissa.
Tori, you are sexually interested in me, are you not?
I told you.
And you are still sexually interested in me.
Okay, fine.
You are, right?
Yes.
Why don't I come over and sleep over your house tonight?
You're very cute.
You really do?
Yeah.
Oh, hurry. You don't want to marry me anymore, Howard?
Aw. Melissa's throwing up from me. All right, listen, Tori, I want you now to make a speech because I got to move this along. Tori, make a speech about how happy you are as one of the stars of Beverly Hills 90210 and the daughter, more importantly, of Aaron Spelling. Talk about why you like the show quickly, just in a couple of sentences, and congratulate me on my number one status. Go ahead, Tori.
Did you get it all?
Go.
Now say it back.
Now say it.
Being one of the stars of 90210 and more importantly, Aaron Spelling's daughter, is that correct?
Yes.
I'm very happy to be here, and congratulations on your number one status.
Yes.
And
you think I'm really cute?
I think you're really cute, and I hope the funeral goes well tomorrow.
Isn't it true that everyone accuses you of being an airhead and of not being bright, and Saturday Night Live did that thing?
That is my character, not me.
That you are smart, are you not?
Yes, I think so.
I'm going to prove it right now. I'm going to give you a series of five questions. I will give you five questions.
Yes.
Answer these questions, and you will prove how smart you are. You ready? Name the man who was the former chief of police in Los Angeles.
Daryl Gates.
Very good.
There's one.
All right, that's one. Who painted the ceiling at the Sistine Chapel? Hey, don't turn around. You're cheating. Now, come here. Look at me. Who painted the Sistine Chapel? Turn around.
Don't.
Who? Who?
Go ahead.
No, don't say anything, Melissa.
Is that right?
Who? Michelangelo's right now. Don't cheat.
I wasn't. I just didn't.
All right. All right, here we go. Are you ready?
Yes.
What famous movie star director is accused of molesting his child?
Woody Allen.
Very good. Okay. Who was on a videotape being beaten by the Los Angeles Police Department?
Ronnie King.
Very good. All right.
So far, so good.
All right. This is your bonus question.
Oh, okay. What do I get if I win?
What is the capital of New York?
Now, first, what do I get if I win?
You get kiss me. What is it? Come here. What is it? What'd you say?
Wrong answer.
No, give me here. I think you were right. Go ahead. Say it.
New Jersey
is the capital of New York? I knew it.
What is it?
You win.
Albany.
New Jersey's a state.
Another state.
Oh, whatever.
Yeah. Why didn't I win?
Well, you get as a consolation prize, you get to kiss me. You have your buttocks. What do you think of that?
What would I have gotten if I'd won?
You would have gotten your fifth
Same
Porsche.
Thing. Yeah.
All right, you missed the bonus question. New Jersey? All right, what happened on November?
I got nervous. I was put on the spot.
What
Give
happened?
Her another one.
All right, what happened November 22nd, 1963?
I don't know.
You don't know?
What?
November 22nd, 1963. Tori, go ahead. Prove it. Your father turned 50.
Oh.
You don't even know your own father.
That is not true.
No?
That is not true.
It is not true? All right. What happened November 22nd?
I don't know.
You do know. Think. November 22nd, 1963.
I feel really stupid. It's all your fault.
I'll give you a hint. I'll give you a hint. This is a hint.
Oh, dear. Would it be a shooting?
A shooting? That is correct. That is the right answer.
Yes.
All right.
Tori, you've congratulated me on my number one status. Yes. And now, Melissa Rivers, you may congratulate me on my number one status. Go ahead.
Howard, congratulations on your number one status in Los Angeles.
Now, Melissa, you're getting your test next.
I knew all the answers for hers.
You knew all the answers?
Yes.
You went to University of Pennsylvania. Tori didn't have that.
Advantage.
She was sent to college.
I'm going to get, like, physics questions or something.
All right, you ready?
Okay.
What is the capital of New York?
Albany.
What happened November 22nd, 1963?
Kennedy was shot.
Kennedy was shot. Tori. Look at Tori's all upset. She didn't get it right. And Kennedy was shot in Albany.
She had more time to think about the question.
What did you say?
Sherry knew the question. She had more time to think about it.
Yeah, of course. Aww. You're a cheater, Melissa. You cheated.
I tried to help you, Tori. I looked at you. You weren't saying anything. Michelangelo.
Believe me, I'm still attracted to you. All right, we got to take a break. Who wants to kiss me goodbye first? Tori? Come on, Tori.
What if we both
we can do it simultaneously.
No, no, not simultaneously. Who wants to kiss me goodbye first? All right, I tell you what.
See, they're fighting over the opportunity.
Why don't you two kiss each other, and I'll watch. All right, I want to thank Tori Spelling, the star of Beverly Hills 90210, and also Aaron's daughter, and who is
and
my...
Candy's daughter. And got that.
I don't care about Candy.
And Randy's sister.
Yeah, I don't care about Randy. I care about you, and I would marry you. And I would teach you about the Kennedy assassination. We would lay in bed, and I would teach you. So who wants to kiss me? Not you, Gary. All right.
Gary's
and
right.
Melissa Rivers, you may congratulate me on my number one status.
Congratulations on your number one status, Howard.
All right. Thank you. And we'll be back with more right after this from Spago in Los Angeles. Tomorrow's the big funeral. Thank you, Tori and Melissa.
Thank you. Thank
All
you.
Right. Right after these words, we'll be back.
Mark and Brian.
Howard Stern from L.A. The triumphal funeral for the two imbeciles will continue in a moment.
The radio show, Howard Stern in the Morning. The station, WLUP Chicago. The frequency, AM 1000, the AM loop.
Jonathan Brandmeier.
Where, oh, where has Super Dave been?
I'm in the hospital right now, and I'm calling for a reason. Normally, yeah. I just call to have fun, but I've been constipated for a week.
Are you serious?
Yes, and they've been feeding me X-Lax intravenously, and it's doing no good.
What's
so
wrong?
They said the only thing that could help is you if you could overnight a Buzz Kelman cassette.
Okay.
Brandmeier with entertainment for the happy hour. Afternoons on AM 1000.
Maybe you're at home relaxing. Maybe you're at work. Whatever you're doing, give it a rest. Because Wilson's, the leather experts, the people who invented affordable leather, are having their first annual drop whatever you're doing or regret it for the rest of your life leather sale. Wilson's is offering the largest selection of adventure-bound leather jackets on Earth and every other planet. That includes quality leather bomber jackets off our rack and on your back for $99.99. Plus a huge selection of three-quarter length coats, long coats, whatever you want in leather. Our prices are so low, they sound like a mistake, but they're not. We also have the perfect gift idea. Leather accessories like men's and ladies' leather gloves starting at just $9.99. So even if you're in the middle of a passionate kiss, unpucker now and get to the drop whatever you're doing or regret it for the rest of your life leather sale. Now at Wilson's, the folks who make leather affordable.
The Wilson's Adventure Bound sale. For the greatest selection of leather jackets you'll find anywhere, go to Wilson's. They've got bomber jackets and cycle jackets starting at just $9.99.